Sean Don, man. Big Sean. You already know I'm on Silk TV.
What's good? It's yours truly, VIP, and we are back. Silk TV and the Friday Feeling Show right here in the Big Smoke in London Town. I'm with a man today that's got more than a few BET awards under his belt. A couple of Grammy nominations as well. His album is currently number one in the US, top five in the UK. Welcome to the UK, Big Sean.
What up, man? What's up?
What's happening,
thanks
bro?
Thanks for having me, dog.
It's good to see you over here.
Yeah, I love it over here, man.
Now, obviously, we're here to talk about that brand new album, that massive album, Dark Sky Paradise.
Yeah.
But just before we get into that, I mean, going back, the first time I really remember hearing Big Sean was on a track, Teriyaki Kings by the Teriyaki Boys with Kanye.
Ooh, that was
back in 2009. That was
back in the day. Wow, you remember that, huh?
I remember that, and I remember specifically the Kanye influence in you then.
Yeah.
Back in 2009. I mean, you signed to Good Music in 2007.
Must have been 2008.
2008. Okay, and then. I mean, what was it like having Kanye as a mentor guiding you through?
Great. Come on, you know, that's the best person to mentor you in music, you know what I mean?
So
it's all good, man. It's, you know, he was my favorite artist before I met him, so you could just imagine what that feels like. You know?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So that's my bro right there, though.
Okay.
And he's taught me a lot.
Yeah.
And I'm sure I've taught him a lot, too, you know what I mean? He's somebody who... He's just, you know, a perfectionist, and he pushes people to that limit creatively and brings the best out of you. So.
Now, last year as well, a lot of people got it twisted because everyone caught wind that you were with Roc Nation and thought that you dropped Good Music and gone to Roc Nation. But to get it straight, Roc Nation handle... the management side of things
with
you nowadays.
Yeah,
I mean, now it's not only Kanye on your back, you got Jay-Z on your back as well.
Yeah.
Two of the biggest, legends in the hip-hop game of the modern era on your back. What's it like having that pressure sitting on your back?
It's no pressure, man. No pressure at all. You gotta realize you're at where you're at for a reason, you know?
Yeah.
So I appreciate it. It's a blessing, but it's no pressure, though. Yeah.
Okay. So, getting into the album, then. We've got first talk about the lead track that popped off, is still popping off in the clubs right now. Probably one of the biggest tunes in the clubs right now that I'm playing. I Don't F With You.
Oh, man. Thank
Absolute
you.
Anthem. Did you realise that would catch on and be as big as it was when you first wrote it?
Hell no. No, I didn't know, but... I'm appreciative of it, and it just goes to show me that people just love real shit, man. They just love real music, things that they could be receptive to or relate to, you know what I mean? And it was just crazy how that song took off on radio, you know. Obviously, as much cursing, as much, you know, the song is called I Don't Fuck With You, you know what I mean? And it's just like, it still like did well. You know, in that aspect. So it's just, that just goes to show that the people really can control and dictate what they want to hear on the radio. And, you know, they really have power. And I've seen that just in a few songs this year, not just mine, not just that song, but I've seen it with No Type with Ray Sherman. You know, that song was like a song that
definitely,
I just heard
yeah.
in the clubs. And then the people just had to, like, you know, translate that to radio. So it's really cool that radio being receptive to like what's going on with the people, and I'm really happy about that, and thankful for I Don't Fuck With You, thankful for E-40 being on there. He's been one of my favorite rappers for a long time, so that meant a lot.
Okay. I mean, the beat as well, because we have to talk about the production side of things. Mustard on the beat, obviously, and Kanye
and
also
Dahir
and Key Wayne getting credits on it as well. I mean, them four producers.
Mike
Free as well. So
five producers.
It's not easy for someone to get a beat off like one of them producers. So the fact that you got
I'm super lucky, right?
Yeah.
Super blessed.
Absolutely blessed.
The reason they were all, you know, able to do that is because we had the song for so long. We were working on it for like a long time, and we would just like, that was one of the first songs I did for the album, so I would be making the rest of the album and always come back to that song. How can we make it better?
Yeah.
You know, Ye came and added the sample to it, but Key Wayne came, brought the sample to the table, and it was, that sample was from another song I had, and we got rid of that song and put the sample to it. And then Dahi did the end part, and Mike Free did the original beat with Mustard. So it was just like a lot of like people put their, you know, their talent to it, and it made it special. You know what I mean? It made it really special. And as soon as E-40 got on there, I just knew that song was, I didn't know, you know, it would be like how it is, but I knew it was something special.
Mm-hmm. So I know a lot of people take the content of the song a little bit too seriously. I've seen a few interviews, people get it twisted about the actual meaning of the song. I know a lot of people think it's about your ex. But
yeah, it makes sense that it would be, right? It's just kind of crazy how timing works. I mean,
yeah. I know you actually penned the tune while you was with your ex, so.
Yeah, so most of that, it's not about her, you know. It's only like a couple lines about her, but you know, that's just
that's where I was getting to. So, could I ask you what lines you put in after? There are specific lines, obviously, aimed.
Yeah.
Yeah. but moving on anyway.
But it's only just a couple. It wasn't a lot. But she heard it before. I mean, I don't even want to get into that. You know, I'm on a...
Yeah.
I'm in a whole, you know...
A whole new place right now
in my life. So, but... people know, you know. But on top of that, though, I'm an artist. It is my responsibility to rap about what I go through in my life. I mean, at least I'm keeping it authentic and real. But... Mm-hmm. You know, if it was about her, I would be like, that song is all about her, but it's just not. I wouldn't lie. It's not all about her.
Getting back to the album, Dark Sky Paradise, it's available right now. Like I said earlier, it's top number 5 in the UK iTunes chart and number 1 in the US iTunes chart.
Mm-hmm.
How does that feel to like put something out there and finally get... I mean, I, as a DJ, as a fan of yours as well, I don't think you get the recognition, or you haven't got the recognition in the past.
Thank you, man.
That you do deserve as an artist. And a lot of people I know have said that you don't get the shine that you deserve as an artist. So do you feel now that you're actually getting the shine that you deserve?
I can't really, you know, I'm kind of focused, so I can't really tell what it's looking like from the outside looking in, but... You know, like I said, I put my heart into this project, man. I recorded the whole thing in my house. I built a studio. You know, I kept it real with myself. I followed my heart. I didn't listen to anybody else. You know, I got my grandma in here on the same song as John Legend and Kanye West. You know, I got my dad on here. I got some of my favorite artists I've ever worked with on here. So I'm happy about it, man. And that's all that matters. I realize you can't measure success in anything but happiness. So that's how you do it.
Okay, and one of the other singles that we have to talk about before we get out of here, the next big tune on the streets right now, Blessings.
Yeah.
Now, I know Kanye actually put a verse on the remix.
Yeah, it wasn't really a remix. It was actually, it would have been the main version. It was just too late. We already had turned the album.
Okay,
and,
that's what I was going to ask you.
It was already like out and in the process, and it was just too, you know, things got mixed up. But that didn't stop us, you know what I mean? It was just like, hey man, we'll put that on iTunes too.
Yeah, because that was a hot verse from Kanye as well on that tune.
But the video version is all three of us.
Big Sean, thank you for taking the time out to come and speak to us today.
Yeah,
thank you for visiting us over here in the UK.
Of course. And shout out to all the UK listeners. I don't really get no UK calls. You know, I gave my phone number out on the album, on the outro. So a lot of people calling me from all over the United States. I don't really get that many UK calls. I don't understand.
I think you need to give the US code as well. The US dialing code.
I mean,
as well.
They would figure that out. They should know.
True.
Dialing code out. It's just like, I'm trying to hear from the UK fans. Call me.
So
I really have a direct line I keep in my pocket, and I'll be like, it rings every second, so just keep calling until I answer.
So if anyone wants to find out more about Big Sean, where they can find your upcoming tour dates, album releases, anything, where's the best place to look on the web?
Just all my social media, just Twitter is @BigSean, Instagram is @BigSean, my Snapchat is BigSeanSnapped. And my website is youknowbigsean.com. It's U, the letter U, KNOWBIGSEAN.com.
There you go, it's all there. So wrapping this one up then, thank you.
What's
for
your
taking
favorite song off the album?
You know what? It's Research.
Research?
Because I can relate to the tune and the lyrics so much.
Deep. A lot of people have been saying that. It might have to be the next single.
Yeah, man. But yeah, thank you for blessing us with the album, Dark Sky Paradise. It's available right now via all digital media outlets, the usual places. Get yourself online and cop that. And thank you for taking the time out to speak to us.